Good morning, my dear children. This is Dr. Vani, and on behalf of Vedantu, I welcome you all to today's session. I hope you're all doing well for yourselves. Good morning. Did you happen to see our super amazing motivation session yesterday? Did you like it? Because I got such beautiful comments on it, and I really don't... I was not expecting that it will touch your hearts in such a beautiful way. The winners don't give up. I'm so grateful to you for all the love that you send our way. It truly, truly, truly makes our life so much more beautiful. Thank you for the kindness. It's very difficult in today's day and age to be kind to everybody. You are extremely kind to Vedantu and Vbiotonic, and for that, the entire team is extremely and eternally grateful. Thank you. Thank you. I'm sure we're making a positive difference in your lives, my dear, my dear children. So let's start today's class with a zoology mega test. You know human physiology is very important, but now in the mega test series, I'm going to attack small portions so that we become absolutely masters of this small portion. From Monday, Tuesday also, we were talking about diseases. So today, I'm going to be doing the diseases of the entire human physiology. Vitamin diseases, aap kar chuke, bhale wo vitamin diseases, ho, respiratory diseases, ho, excretory diseases, ho, right? Ho sakta hai reproductive diseases bhi ho, because it's human physiology. So the entire gamut of complete diseases we are going to be doing in today's class. Are you ready with your OMR sheets? Are you ready with your OMR sheets? Shreya, Naresh, Artika, Shweta, everybody, ready with your OMR sheets? And make sure everybody likes, share, subscribes after the class. Immediately after the class, I should start getting your scores in plus fours and minus ones. Cool? Immediately class ke baad mujhe aap logon ke score plus four minus one mein zoology mega test ke mil jane chahiye. Aapko pata hai, ek din baad botany ka mega test aane wala. Tomorrow I will release the syllabus of it. Cool? Chaliye. Let's start diseases of human physiology. Episode number 4 hai ye zoology mega test ka. We've already done 3 episodes of zoology mega test. So make sure that all the other episodes also, if you've still not watched them till now, you watch them. So let's move ahead, my dear kids. Chalo aage bade. Choti si aapko baatein bata dete. Aaj respiration and plants mein I'm going to be doing the electron transport chain. Kal kuch crash corians ne bohat amazing tarah se. Kitne bache crash corians hai? Raise your hands. कितने प्यारे बच्चे यहाँ मेरे क्रैश कोरियंस कौन कौन है. सो उन्होंने बहुत अच्छे से मेरे से रेस्पिरेशन एंड प्लांट्स में इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसपोर्ट चेन समझा था. आज आप लोगों की बारी है. यस ओ लवली क्रैश, बट क्रैश कोरियंस एक बार मार्क करवाना है एनसीईआरटी से भी. राइट अब तो बहुत एनसीईआरटी मार्किंग शुरू हो जाएंगी आप लोगों की. बट डोंट फॉरगेट वी बायोटॉनिक गॉट यू एनसीईआरटी मार्किंग फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम. यस एवरीबडी, सो मेक श्योर बच्चों दैट यू रेज यू डू दी एनसीईआरटी मार्किंग ऑल्सो, बिकॉज बहुत छोटी छोटी चीजें होती है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आज सुबह वाले बैच को मैं फोटोसिंथेसिस एनसीईआरटी मार्किंग करवा रही थी. तो फोटोसिंथेसिस में ही मैंने उनको एक दो चीजें पूछ ली. जैसे अच्छा आप लोगों से पूछती हूँ एनसीईआरटी मार्किंग की फोटोसिंथेसिस वाला चैप्टर से, वॉट काइंड ऑफ अ ओवरलैप इज सीन इन एक्शन एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रम. बताइए, हो सकता है इसी साल क्वेश्चन आ जाए. वॉट काइंड ऑफ एन ओवरलैप इज सीन इन एक्शन एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रम. बताइए. I am good, Harshada. What kind of a overlap? Come on, Priya. This is going to be on Menti. Yes, overlap. NCERT ki line hai. Very good, Manmeet Kaur. One-to-one overlap. Maine underline bhi karwaya tha. So, NCERT se bohat sare questions aate hain. One-to-one. Is that clear? Thank you, my dear Shreya. So, make sure that you come for the NCERT marking series. Aaj last lecture hai respiration in plants ka. Then I'm going to be doing sense organs, concept building for NEET 2020, and I promise you have not seen a class like this. So make sure that you come for the sense organs class at 12 o'clock. Correct? Ek baar aapko main timetable bhi dikha deti hu aaj ka. Mega zoology test chal raha hai, fir respiration and plants at 10 o'clock, 12 o'clock we are doing sense organs, 5 o'clock we are doing biological classification dobara and sexual reproduction flowering plants ka lecture number 8. Biological classification ka lecture number 3. राइट एवरीबडी, कल हमने डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन ट्रिपल फ्यूजन किया था, आज हम इसको एम्ब्रियोजेनेसिस में आगे बढ़ाएंगे. टुडे इज ऑल्सो महामेंटी इन द इवनिंग एट 9 o'clock, डोंट फॉरगेट इट. टेलीग्राम ग्रुप इज द मोस्ट हैपनिंग टेलीग्राम ग्रुप, ऑलरेडी क्लोज टू 33,000. न्यूएस्ट चैनल ऑफ वेदांतु, वन ऑफ द न्यूएस्ट चैनल, और सबसे ज्यादा टेलीग्राम सब्सक्राइबर्स हमारे पास है. राइट इन बच्चों के साथ मैं आपको रोज एक बात बताती हूँ बच्चों, आई वॉन्ट टू सी योर फोटोग्राफ्स, आई वॉन्ट टू सी यू हियर, एंड फॉर दैट, फॉर अस टू बी एबल टू हेल्प यू, फॉर अस टू डू ग्रेट थिंग्स फॉर यू, यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट यू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आर सुपर अमेजिंग चैनल vdnt.in/ytlive. Entire Vedantu is free from you for grades 1 to 12. Do join so that you are able to appreciate what all extra classes we are taking for you. छोटी सी इन्फॉर्मेशन, नीट का क्रैश कोर्स एक और नया शुरू हुआ है. आई ऑल्सो टेक क्रैश कोर्स, पर बहुत टीचर्स हैं क्रैश कोर्स के, बहुत बैचेस हैं. इफ यू फील द नीड, इफ यू फील दैट यू नो आई रिक्वायर सम एक्स्ट्रा हेल्प, सम हैंड होल्डिंग, स्पेशली इन फिजिक्स एंड केमिस्ट्री इट्स नॉट दैट स्ट्रॉन्ग, आई नीड एक्स्ट्रा हेल्प इन दैट, डू मेक श्योर दैट यू ज्वाइन आवर क्रैश कोर्स, बिकॉज वी हैव डेली लाइव सेशंस, टू ऑफ देम डेली. वी हैव टू सेशंस, वन बॉटनी, वन जूलॉजी, वन फिजिक्स, वन केमिस्ट्री. And it's available to you at a lightning deal of just 5,999 if you use the code of Walima VD NEET. Chale. So VDIT.in/NEET crash course pe jaake you have to do it. The code is 379067. Aa jaiye. 379067 is the code. So let's start. Oh, the code is different here. Menti code is 243847. 243847. Anushka Ghosh is here. 243847. 243847. Chaliye. And everybody join. Waiting for 10 seconds for everybody to join. Joint Akanksha, Rajesh, Naresh, Vanshika, Sandeep, Akash, Faiz. Chali, jaldi, jaldi, jaldi. So we have 600 people who've joined. Ho gaya 10 second. Aastha Karan, so sweet. How are you, Aastha? Long time. Giving you some more time. Jaya, Samir, Madhav, Ankit. Okay, should we move ahead? Join? Chali, chali, chali. Come on, guys, you know the time. And you know that you have to join quickly. Gunjan, I will do it. I told you I will reply back to your message in some time. So 700 people joined. Come on, quick, quick, quick. Thank you, Sangeeta Chauhan. Chali, let's move ahead. Five, four, three, two, one, and let's move ahead. Start the quiz. So I'm starting the quiz, guys. Ready? OMRs ready. Plus fours, minus one. Menti does not matter. What matters is your accuracy. What matters is that you know the answer and you also know when to not do negative. So today, how many of you have problems with a lot of negatives? Raise your hands, ma'am. Negative jata hai. Aaj aapne negative mark nahi karna hai. Done. We'll do. We'll try it one more time. Pratiksha, you are late. Right. Today we will try not to do negatives. Right, Shikha. Done. Agar negative ke saath problem hai, aaj ya. Dekha. I want to really see. 300 bachche bhi answer karenge. That is fine. But negative nahi karna. That temptation. How many of you get tempted? Shit. That temptation. Oh my God. Answer kar hi dete hai. राइट ये आदत डेवलप करके बनेगी. आपको लग रहा है अभी तो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, अभी तो आंसर कर देते हैं, बट एग्जाम में भी सेम हैबिट कंटिन्यूज. यस एवरीबडी, सेम हैबिट विल कंटिन्यू. देखो जिसको जैसी आदत होती है उसको वैसी ही आदत रहती है. ये तो आप हैबिट्स डाई हार्ड. राइट, अगर किसी को कॉपी करने की आदत है तो उसको कॉपी करने की आदत ही लगी रहेगी. किसी को ज्यादा खाने की आदत पड़ जाए, मीठा अच्छा लगने लग जाए, तो उसको मीठा ही अच्छा लगेगा. यस, सो हैबिट्स डाई हार्ड, इजंट इट? Isn't it? So let's try it today. सच में है ना, habits ऐसे एक दिन में नहीं होती है. किसी को अगर नकल करने की आदत लग जाए तो वो नकल करेगा, किसी को मीठा खाने की आदत लग जाए तो वो मीठा खाएगा या खाएगी. सो सिमिलरली अगर किसी को जो भी आदत लग जाए, सो हैबिट्स डाई हार्ड, लेट्स ट्राई चेंज आवर हैबिट्स इन टुडेज क्लास. मूविंग अहेड, राइट, डिसऑर्डर्स ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. अब हाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डू इट, बहुत ज्यादा मैंने अच्छी स्लाइड बनाई है सो दैट आपको कंफ्यूजन ना हो और नेगेटिव मार्क्स अवॉइड हो. पहले मैं समझाऊंगी फिर क्वेश्चन लूंगी, फिर समझाऊंगी फिर क्वेश्चन लूंगी. डन, कूल, यस एवरीबडी. फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन, मेंटी कोड है आपका 243847, पर पहले आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट, देन आई विल मूव ऑन टू द एमसीक्यूज एंड आई विल टेल यू अ लॉट ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा पॉइंट्स. कूल, मेक हार्ट्स, इज इट अनर्बन, थग लाइफ. यार क्या करें, अभी 10 साल से पढ़ा रहे हैं, थोड़ा बहुत थग लाइफ तो हो ही जाएगा, है ना? वो भी वेदांत जैसे प्लेटफॉर्म पे पढ़ा रहे हैं तो थोड़ा थग लाइफ तो चाहिए. यस एवरीबडी, दिस पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ लाइफ, नो. चलिए आ जाइए एम्फाइसीमा. ओके, सो एम्फाइसीमा इज अ रिडक्शन इन द एल्वियोलर वेंटिलेशन. व्हाट इज वेंटिलेशन? गैसेस गोइंग इन एंड आउट. सो व्हेन द गैसेस, द इन एंड आउट ऑफ द गैसेस इज अफेक्टेड, दैट्स कॉल्ड एज एम्फाइसीमा. एम्फाइसीमा इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज क्रॉनिक बिकॉज इट डज नॉट हैपन इन वन डे. रिमेंबर, एक्यूट इज सडन. COVID-19 is acute. COVID-19 does not come in NEET exams. I must have told it 1,000 times. COVID-19 will help you increase subscribers on YouTube. That's why Vedantu Biotronic did not do it. But COVID-19 will not come on in exams. Right? COVID-19 se subscribers zarur badh jayenge, par exam mein number nahi aayenge. So, chronic obstructive pulmonary. Now, don't call me thug life again, okay? I'm just telling the truth. If truth makes you say thug life, that's a different story. Right. So, chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder is nothing but your emphysema. It's chronic. It takes a long time. Right. It takes a long time to come. Is that clear? Aajaiye. It's a reduction in the alveolar ventilation. The exchange of gases goes down. Very important. What you need to understand, which is not written in the book, is definitely the elasticity of the alveoli goes down. Pin drop silence in my class, please. Definitely the elasticity of the alveoli goes down, which is very important. But what is not written and on which questions will come is the alveoli are joined by septae. So there are these septas which join the alveoli. Septas. If you read other books, you will come to know this. On the basis of this, AIMS questions will come. Slide is clear. Everything is clear. It's clear, my dear Gayatri. Please pay attention. It's absolutely clear. So the septae are destroyed because of smoking. Smoking has got carcinogens. Smoking has got dangerous material which destroys the septae. When the septae are destroyed, the expansion and really the contraction expansion of the alveoli goes down, right? Because of which they always, now see, this is a normal alveoli and this is an alveoli which will always remain inflated. If the alveoli remains inflated, the internal going and external coming of the gas is affected. Gas always remains here. Gas will always remain here only. Right, everybody? It will only remain in the alveoli. It will not exchange. This is also referred to as dead space. Right, everybody? So the dead space is there. Right? Distension, matlab phool jayenge, distension of alveolar sacs and bronchioles, they will remain swollen because the septae have destroyed. Remember the word septae, they will remain distended. Cigarette smoking and chronic bronchitis are the causes of this disease. In this, the alveolar sac remains filled with air even after expiration, that is the dead space. They do not cause ventilation. This word is important. Ventilation, distension means it remains open, caused by cigarette smoking. It's a chronic disease. There's obstruction in the flow of gases. The sacs remain filled with air. There is no ventilation which is happening, because of which the person has a puffed up appearance. That's why they are called as pink puffers and blue bloaters. When you go to college, you will read the words. You can even Google them now. Pink puffers, blue bloaters. Naam se obviously emphysema ko bulaya jata hai. Cyanotic conditions bhi ho sakti because amount of oxygen in the blood can go down. So this entire disease I've explained. This disease must have come at least 6 or 7 times. I'm sure you will be able to answer this disease MCQs now. On your screens, MCQs, please. So let's start the quiz. Chaliye. Right? Come on, Julie, Vanshika. Technical name. Why is it technical? Today morning also that batch we did the same thing. Technical. Technical name. Come on, 16 seconds. Answering well. Answering very well. That's a good one. That's a very good one. Right? Now, let's do this in a lot of detail. Right, everybody? Very good. Now, the heart attack is usually going to happen when the blood supply to the heart is compromised. Let me draw a nice diagram here only and explain this to you. So, when the blood supply to the heart is compromised, very good. Plus 4 over here. Now, see, this is your heart. This is your heart. Right, everybody? And this is your coronary artery. This is your aorta. So, we'll make one more, which comes out right from here. It's called your coronary artery, which supplies the right coronary artery. If the coronary artery, now this is very important, the mind map which I'm going to be making now, if the coronary artery gets blocked by a thrombus or an embolus, there are two words which you should remember for it. Please write down every word. The thrombus, okay, clot or an embolus. Embolus can usually be air. Embolus can also be amniotic fluid. That's why so many mothers often pass away or die while delivery, because it could be an embolus, the amniotic emboli, amniotic fluid. So because of which, this portion is called the muscle of the heart. Let's call it myocardia. So oxygen is not going to come because there is a clot here. Are you getting my point? There is a clot, thrombus, clot, atherosclerosis bhi jisko keh sakte ho aap log. I will come to that later. So because of which, decreased blood supply to the muscle of the heart. Decreased blood supply to the muscle of the heart is called as ischemia. Write it down. Ischemia. Ischemia is decreased blood supply to the muscle of the heart. When there is decreased blood supply to the muscle of the heart, the tissue of the heart dies. The muscles die. That's called as infarct. Infarct is dead tissue because of decreased blood supply. Infarct is referred to as a myocardial infarct because it's the muscle of the heart. So when the muscle of the heart is dead, it will cause a lot of pain. The pain is angina, which is a very, very, very strong pain, and pectoris, because the chest muscle is called as pectoralis major. The muscle is called as pectoris. So I repeat, when the coronary artery gets blocked, thrombus, embolus. I think we missed the first question. I'll come back to it. Don't worry, that was an emphysema. The muscle receives less blood, which is called as ischemia. The tissue dies, which is called as infarct, and causes pain, which is called as angina pectoris. The mind map is very important, my dear kids. It's a complication due to reduced blood supply to the heart wall, pain, precipitation is sweating, nausea, and changes in the electrocardiograph. Understood? One more thing which you need to understand is, there is something in the human body which is called as myotome. What do you understand by myotome? By myotome, we understand the muscles which are supplied by a single nerve during development. So the entire this muscle, the muscle on the inner side of the left hand. So if I have to show you my left hand, exactly, that'll be my left hand, right up to the thumb, the little finger, and to the angle of the jaw. So the pain is all over. I have seen cases where they came with a pain in the third molar, but on doing the ECG, we realized that there was a heart attack. Moving ahead to the next question on my screen, please. Fast. Test plus knowledge gain at the same time is seriously amazing. Thickening of the arteries due to cholesterol deposition. You know the answer. I will do that neat crack, Guruji. Chali aaiye, aage badhiye. Chaliye, chaliye, chaliye. Thickening of the arteries. The arteries will thicken, their diameters will decrease, the elasticity will come down. Cardiac arrest, blood pressure, rheumatic heart, wherein the valves are damaged because of antibodies produced against streptococcus. I think it's mandibular. Very well done. It's arteriosclerosis. There are two major reasons for arteriosclerosis. It happens because of cigarette smoking. The nicotine which is present in cigarette smoking causes vasoconstriction. In vasoconstriction, the plaques are deposited, the calcium, the cholesterol is deposited. Very well done. Those of you who are coming new, the code is 243847. 243847. Nicotine. Is that clear? So 679 of you have answered well. And then when the plaque will deposit, this artery which they are showing is the coronary artery. Middle meningeal arteries are all parts of the coronary artery supplying the brain. So aorta ki pehli branch hoti hai coronary artery. The carotid artery, and carotid artery se do banti hai, right carotid, left carotid, or the internal and the external carotid of the right and left each. It is a thickening and narrowing of lumen. Kya aapko yahan narrowing of lumen nazar aa raha hai? Narrowing of lumen happens because of vasoconstriction, or vasoconstriction happens because of cigarette smoking. Is that clear? Vasoconstriction. A yellow colored plaque. Plaque is called as atheroma, which is cholesterol, which is lipids are deposited on the inner media of the arteries. Arteries always have the tunica media thicker. Veins have the tunica media thinner. Veins have valves. Arteries do not have valves. Right? Thickening of the walls of smaller arteries and arteriolosis is common in elderly people because elasticity also comes down. Cigarette smoking decreases the elasticity. The code is 243847. 243847. 243847. Right? Bacho, ek baar code likh do. Aur plus 4, minus 1 mein apna score bata dijiye. See the built up of the plaque. Dekhiye. इतना ठीक हो गया है. Have you heard of something called balloon angioplasty? Balloon angioplasty is done to remove the thickening. Have you heard of balloon angioplasty? Streptokinase भी देते हैं initially जब clot form होता है. Right? Thrombus को remove करने के लिए heparin दे सकते हैं, streptokinase दे सकते हैं, balloon angioplasty कर सकते हैं. Correct? चलिए. Next questions on your screen, please. The code is 243847. 243847. Damage to the alveolar walls. Very good question. There is a damage to the alveolar walls. Whose elasticity will go? Blood vessel ki elasticity jayegi na, Pankaj ji. Name the pulmonary disease in which alveolar surface area involved in gas exchange is drastically reduced. Chaliye. Very good, very good. That means you understood what I told you right in the beginning of the class. Very good, emphysema. Emphysema? Yes, everybody. Wah, wah, wah. Bacho, aaj toh bahut hi kamal kar rahe ho. Very good. It is emphysema, the elasticity reduces, right? Chale, next question. Oh, very good question. I will explain this in detail. Very good question. Chaliye. Very good question. Okay, Sadhana. What is glomerulonephritis? Itis means something. Itis is something. What is that itis? Otitis, laryngitis, pharyngitis, hepatitis, salpingitis, meningitis, arthritis. Wow! NCRT marking करने का फायदा हुआ, it is nothing but inflammation of the kidney, but there's something else which I want to tell you. It questions may not be that simple when they come in the examination, right? So let me just take 10 seconds and explain something to you which is important from glomerulonephritis point of view. Now, this is the visceral peritoneum, correct? The inner one, the outer one is a parietal one. So, you know, here there will be podocytes and all. If there is inflammation of the glomerulus, if there is inflammation, I'm writing it here. Can you all see it? I want to tell you something very important which can come in the assertion reason type of questions which come. So, if there is inflammation in the glomerulus, you should understand, if there is inflammation, what is going to happen is that the slits or the pores for filtration, which are called the filtration slits, or the fenestrae, they are going to increase. This is what happens in all types of inflammation. The diameter of the slits, the fenestrae always increases. Can anybody in the class put two and two together and tell me what will I find in the urine? Anybody, if it comes in an Ames type of assertion reason MCQ, once there is glomerulonephritis, anybody, Gaurav, anybody, Anushka, the leaderboard will come. Is it Maria? Thank you. Okay, my dear Shazia, agar inflammation ho jati hai bachcho, to ye jo slits aur fenestrae hai, inke beech mein gaps badh jate hai because of inflammation. Uski wajah se aapka glucose aur protein यूरिन में आने लगेगा, which is called as glucose urea and protein urea. तो अगर इसी क्वेश्चन को मैंने ट्विस्ट कर दिया, बिकॉज स्पेस बढ़ गई ना, स्पेस बढ़ गई, तो ग्लूकोज और प्रोटीन यूरिन में आने लगेगा. सो अगर आपसे पूछा गया प्रोटीन यूरिया किस डिजीज में आएगा, आंसर इसका होगा ग्लोमेरुलोनेफ्राइटिस. ग्लूकोज यूरिया कौन सी डिजीज में होगा, आंसर होगा ग्लोमेरुलोनेफ्राइटिस. नेफ्राइटिस इज द इन्फ्लेमेशन. जब इन्फ्लेमेशन, जब भी सूजन होगी, द स्लिट्स डायमीटर विल इंक्रीज लीडिंग टू फिल्ट्रेशन. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस, अंडरस्टूड? ब्लड लार्ज. सो वट इज द पैथोग्नोमिक और द डायग्नोस्टिक साइन? देखो आधे डॉक्टर तो आप अभी बन रहे हो. आई रियली एंजॉय टीचिंग लाइक दिस वेर यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड, पुट टू एंड टू टूगेदर, है ना. तो जब भी ये डायमीटर बढ़ेगा, ग्लूकोज एंड प्रोटीन विल बी एबल टू कम आउट. वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. सो पाइलोनेफ्राइटिस इज यूजली द पस सेल्स विच आर सीन, पस सेल्स कम. एंड ग्लोमेरुलोनेफ्राइटिस इज नथिंग बट द डायग्नोस्टिक साइन. कब कब डॉक्टर सोचेगा कि यार मैं ग्लोमेरुलोनेफ्राइटिस के बारे में सोचता हूँ, वेन continuously blood and glucose will be seen in the urine. Inflammation of the glomerulus due to injury, bacterial toxins, drugs. It can also happen because of stones. Accumulation of urea and blood due to malfunctioning of kidneys, uremia, right? Highly harmful and usually a consequence of kidney or renal failure is uremia. Uremia ki wajah se jab itna badh jayega, it might lead to delusions. It might lead to, you know, a type of a senility or madness. So in logo mein you have to undergo dialysis. Hemodialysis karna padega. Dialysis do type ka hota hai. Peritoneal dialysis, jab aapke peritoneal membrane ko ek dialysis membrane ki tarah use karte hai, which is very rare. Nowadays they do hemodialysis. But you should know there are two types of dialysis, peritoneal dialysis and hemodialysis. Next questions on your screens, please. I hope you are making notes, please, side by side. You're doing plus four, minus one. You're making notes. Thank you, Noob Transformation. The code is 243847, please. 243847. Oh, renal calculi. Sangeeta, Rathor, Soham. Yes, my dear Soham. Binod, Julie, Secret Girl, Roy, Akansha. Renal calculi. What is renal calculi? Gopika, come on. Kaif, Goody Singh, Atika, Rupali, Supriya, Pungalu, Meenu Kudi, Gaurav, Manjusha, Tushar, Payal. What is renal calculi? It's an insoluble mass. It's not soluble, it's an insoluble mass. But the doctor, see how you treat it. Number one, the amount of water that you drink is more so that it can be flushed out by the body. But if that does not happen, the laser treatment is the second best option. So what happens is with laser, you erode it inside only. You don't really operate for renal stones, no. You operate for gallbladder stones. You operate for cholelithiasis. Call word is used for gallbladder, liver. You don't operate for kidney stones. So with a laser, you hit the laser with the stone, it breaks into small pieces. It's definitely painful and it is pushed out of the body. Right? Is that clear? Chaliye. Please remember the code is 243847. See? Renal calculi, kidney stones formed by precipitation of uric acid. That's why it's told to not hold urine for a long period of time. There are salts in the urine. So people who hold urine for a long period of time, salts precipitate kar dete. Colic pain in the back. Pain is here. Colic pain. Spreading down to the thigh. Stone may pass into the ureter or urinary bladder. And sometimes they may stop urine. Say they may even obstruct if they are big. At this time, you have to use laser therapy, break the stone into small pieces. The code is 243847. For those of you who just joined, the code is 243847. Awesome diagram. Thank you, guys. And guys, remember always, obviously we sometimes laugh in the beginning of the class, like how we were laughing and just having fun. But as doctors, as somebody who's a doctor, as somebody who's taken the Hippocratic Oath, and as people like you who will take the Hippocratic Oath to help mankind, to serve mankind, and as Indian doctors, where our core philosophy is Sarve Santu Niramaya. Yes or no? Right? So obviously having a little bit fun in the beginning of the class and all that is fine. But as people who will take the Hippocratic Oath tomorrow, as doctors who will pledge to save the world, as doctors who will be warriors to save the world in terms of any crisis that humanity is suffering as now also, as people who are Indian doctors and as Indian doctors, you will stand by the oath of Sarve Santu Niramaya. Yes, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinam. right? It's this statement, this Sanskrit statement, I get goosebumps even now when I recite this Sanskrit statement. Sanskrit is a language of India. It's not a religious language. It's absolutely irreligious. And Sarve Santu Niramya means we are praying for universal, you know, universal happiness. And again, as Indians who believe in the philosophy of Vasudev Kutumbakam, yes, so we believe that the entire world is one universe. We are a part of a microcosm, which we belong to a bigger macrocosm. And then when we think of these four philosophies, laughing, having fun is a different thing. But what is most important is mutual love, mutual respect. And even more important, my dear children, is the ability to serve mankind. So each one of my warriors, and I'm going to call you my biotonic warriors, because you are going to be real warriors in tomorrow's world. Yes, you will. I pray from all my heart you take the Hippocratic Oath to serve mankind tomorrow, and you believe in the philosophy of Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah. Yes, no? Yes, that makes us so much more positive and happy about life. Chali, next question on the screens, please, with that. So kis kis ko Hippocratic Oath leni hai? Answer kijiye. Yes, biotonic warriors, I will do that very soon. Bilkul sadhana. Beta, single option correct bola hai, toh aane ke chance hai assertion and reason. Come on guys, 1,080 people watching, 530 likes, kanjuso. Maha kanjus, itne kanjus bachche toh dunya mein kahin nahi milenge. Yes, chalo yahan like mat karna, kisi din patient ko free mein treat kar diya karna. Gareeb patient se paise mat lena. अपना ओपीडी हफ्ते में एक दिन फ्री रखना, वहां कंजूसी मत दिखाना. हीमोडायलिसिस, आई टोल्ड यू व्हाट इज डायलिसिस. सी फॉर कैरेट हलवा. यस, हीमोडायलिसिस इज अ प्रोसेस वेयर यू रिमूव द यूरिया. आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट टू टाइप्स ऑफ डायलिसिस. पेरिटोनियल डायलिसिस वेयर द पेरिटोनियल मेम्ब्रेन इज यूज्ड एज अ डायलिसिस एंड समटाइम्स यू हैव टू टेक इट आउटसाइड द बॉडी. यहां कैन्यूला लगाते हैं, यहां कैन्यूला. रोज के रोज इंजेक्शन नहीं लगाएंगे. तो एक आपके वेन के अंदर, मेन वेन के अंदर एक कैन्यूला डाल के, कैन्यूलाइजेशन देखा है आपने? कैथेटर तो देखा होगा, यहां कैथेटर लगाते हैं, राइट? कैन्यूला लगाते हैं. कैथेटराइजेशन इज ऑल्सो डन फॉर रिमूवल ऑफ द यूरिन, राइट? तो यहां पर जिनको भी अगर आपने देखा होगा किसी का हीमोडायलिसिस हो रहा है, यहां बॉडी, यहां पर कैन्यूला लगाकर छोड़ देते हैं इस जगह पर, यहां. तो यहां स्वेलिंग हो जाती है, राइट? किडनी, रीनल फेलियर इज अ मेडिकल कंडीशन वेयर द फाइनल वेस्ट कैन नॉट बी रिमूव फ्रॉम द बॉडी. यूरिया चला जाएगा ब्रेन में, ब्लड यूरिया लेवल जब बढ़ जाएंगे, इट विल लीड टू डिलूरियम, इट विल लीड टू मैडनेस, इट विल लीड टू टॉक्सिसिटी, लिवर फेलियर हो जाएगा अगर नहीं कम हुआ, राइट? सो एक सेलोफेन ट्यूब होती है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. और डायलिसिंग यूनिट के पास, फ्रॉम द डायलिसिंग यूनिट वी पुट इट इन द ट्यूब, राइट? और फ्लूइड ऑफ द सेम कॉम्पोजिशन एज प्लाज्मा. नाइट्रोजन नहीं होता, सो यू आर पुटिंग इट समवेयर. डायलिसिस फ्लूइड इन, यहां नाइट्रोजन नहीं होगा, सो ऑल द नाइट्रोजन विल गो आउट. विदाउट नाइट्रोजन द प्लाज्मा विल बी विदाउट नाइट्रोजन. आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? यस, डन. और फिर वापस वी विल पुट इट इन द बॉडी. आर्टरी से निकालेंगे, वेन में डाल देंगे, यहां पर कैन्यूला लगा देंगे. अंडरस्टूड? नाइट्रोजनस वेस्ट जो होंगे मूव आउट कर जाएंगे, बिकॉज ऑफ फ्लूइड जो हमने रखा है सेमी परमीबल मेम्ब्रेन के इस तरफ. इट इज आइसोटोनिक टू प्लाज्मा बट इट हैज नो यूरिया. और जो ब्लड आ रहा है, इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ यूरिया, सो द यूरिया विल गो आउट. द ब्लड इज हैज अ लॉट ऑफ यूरिया. वेरी गुड. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन प्लीज ऑन योर स्क्रीन. चलिए, which of the following is not inflammatory? Very good question. Yes, Noob. Chaliye, pay attention. Rajendra, Noob, Manish, Harshil, Vanshika, Alok Kumar Yadav, Subalekha, Sudhanshu, Iota. How are you? Gayatri, Snehil, Harshil, Faiz, Deepa, Nainshi, Numan, Dipanshi, Arunendra, Tanisha, Manish. Bataiye, gout, which is non-inflammatory? Faizala, Tanisha, Sadaf, Soren. Which of the following is not inflammatory arthritis? I will go with D. I'll also go with D. I'll explain this. It should be D. Right? It should be D. It should be D. No worries. See, what is non-inflammatory? Basically, to be very honest with you, the option was myasthenia gravis, the last one. I will tell you what each one of them stands for and then let's discuss on this question. Gout is when the uric acid increases. It goes to the small joints. I use black pen so that everybody is it's clearly seen. Uric acid increases. It goes to the small joints. और स्मॉल जॉइंट्स में इंफ्लमेशन हो जाती है. इंफ्लमेशन हो जाती है, करेक्ट है एवरीबॉडी? अब मैं आपको बताती हूं आप लोग थोड़ा सा कंफ्यूज हो गए. आई विल टेल यू, दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी नाइस क्वेश्चन, ब्यूटीफुल क्वेश्चन, वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. मैं आपको समझाती हूँ. सेकेंड, अर्थराइटिस एंड रूमैटिक फीवर. रूमैटिक फीवर में एंटीबॉडीज बनती है बेटा. बहुत बहुत उमदा क्वेश्चन है, ऐसा क्वेश्चन आपने कहीं नहीं देखा होगा. एंटीबॉडीज बनती है रूमैटिक फीवर में और ये जो एंटीबॉडीज होती हैं, ये नी जॉइंट, साइनोवियल जॉइंट को डिस्ट्रॉय करती हैं. बस आप मुझे एक बात बताइए, जस्ट टेल मी वन थिंग. व्हेनेवर आई यूज द वर्ड एंटीबॉडी, जस्ट टेल मी वन थिंग, व्हेनेवर आई यूज द वर्ड एंटीबॉडी, इज इट गोइंग टू मीन इन्फ्लेमेशन? Just say, because antigen-antibody reaction tabhi hoga when the antibodies come out of the RBCs. Antibody coming out of the RBC means it is an inflammatory reaction. There is 500% guarantee of it. I can give you a 1000% guarantee that antigen-antibody reaction means inflammation, because basophils will become active, eosinophils will become active, neutrophils will become active. So myasthenia gravis, there are antibodies against the receptors. That means it is an inflammatory reaction. Is that clear? Is that clear? And osteoarthritis is because of decreased calcium, which happens because of old age, when there is decreased estrogen and progesterone in women, because of which calcium is not deposited to the bones. There is absolutely nothing inflammatory in it. Did you understand? This is autoimmune is inflammatory. That is why you give corticosteroids. The only treatment of autoimmunity is corticosteroids, and corticosteroids are steroids decrease immunity. किसी के घर में अगर किसी को कोई inflammatory long term बीमारी है, उनको पता है corticosteroids देने पड़ते हैं. वाइसलोन, प्रेडनिजोलोन, जो आप इनहेलर्स भी लेते हो उसमें भी पढ़िएगा आप, कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड्स होते हैं. आया समझ में? गूगली क्वेश्चन, मजा आया? मेक हार्ट्स. देखा? यस एवरीबॉडी, आया समझ में? ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिस में सेकेंडरी इन्फ्लेमेशन होगी, इन्फ्लेमेशन नहीं होगी. ऑब्वियसली ऑस्टियोक्लास्ट, जब बोन में दर्द होगी, जब बोन में खड्डे हो जाएंगे, तो उसके बाद आप कह सकते हो कि इन्फ्लेमेशन हो रही है. इन ऑल ऑटोइम्यून, जहां पर भी एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी रिएक्शन, इट इज इम्यून रिएक्शन. ऑब्वियसली जब हड्डी बेचारी चकना चूर होने वाली होगी, हड्डी, आपको मैंने कल भी एक वर्ड बोला था, रेडियो न्यूसेंस ही आती है. मैं आपको एक्सरे दिखाऊंगी, डॉक्टर ऐसे एक्सरे देखता है ऐसे लाइट के सामने रख के, हड्डी दिखती नहीं थी, पूरी रेडियो ल्यूसेंस. देयर इज एब्सोल्युटली नो बोन दैट यू कैन सी, इट यूज्ड टू बी एब्सोल्युटली रेडियो ल्यूसेंस, नो रेडियो ओपेसिटीज वर सीन. Right? So obviously at that stage, little bit inflammatory reactions will happen, but it's basically because of weakness, because of less estrogen and progesterone, because of which calcium is not absorbed. That's osteoarthritis. It's not happening because of an inflammatory reaction. Everything else is happening because of an inflammatory reaction. Why is there pain in the joints? Because there is an inflammatory reaction. You get my point? Understood? All one BABD is happening because of an inflammatory reaction. Here, because of decreased strength of the bone, later on inflammatory reaction might occur. Osteoarthritis. Right. Rheumatoid arthritis, and it affects the cartilages. It is a degenerative joint disease. There is degeneration. It's age related. There is low calcium. It's a degenerative joint disease. Understood? Rheumatoid arthritis, gout arthritis are inflammatory joint diseases. This is a degeneration. It happens in age. It's not because of inflammation. It's because of low calcium. Wear and tear happens in osteoarthritis. Very good question. Excellent question. Next question on your screens, please be quick. Arey yaar, ye sabse easy question aa chuka hai. Isse easy question nahi aa sakta aapke exam mein. Chalo, full speed. Full ma'am ne bola, se bhi raised to power infinity ma'am ne bola. Chalo. चलो 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 मेरे प्यारे बच्चों, जिन जिन ने हिपोक्रेटिक ओथ देनी है, चलिए लगाइए, स्टार मार्क कीजिए. व्हाइट कोट पहनना है, स्टेथोस्कोप करना है, दिन में एक दिन ओपीडी फ्री करनी है, हफ्ते में एक दिन. यहां लाइक नहीं करेंगे तो ओपीडी कैसे फ्री करोगे एक दिन? चलो फटाफट गाउट अर्थराइटिस. यस, नंबर टू इज गाउट. रूमेटॉइड नहीं है, ऑस्टियो नहीं है, गाउट. उठ जाओ, ऑल द अबव वाले उठ जाओ, सोते मत रहो. गाउट अर्थराइटिस इज ड्यू टू एक्सेसिव फॉर्मेशन ऑफ यूरिक एसिड और इनएबिलिटी टू एक्सक्रीट इट. मैंने आपको कितनी बार बोला, अगर किसी के घर में भी किसी को गाउट अर्थराइटिस है तो दवाई खोल के देखिए, उसमें एलोप्यूरिनॉल लिखा होगा. आधे डॉक्टर तो आप क्लास में बन जाओगे. एलोप्यूरिनॉल रिमूव्स द यूरिक एसिड. It's because of uric acid. Is that clear? Osteoporosis is because of hormonal imbalances like calcitonin and parathormon. Punch disease कहते हैं. I remember जब college में हमें इसके X-rays दिखाए जाते थे, तो punching machine देखी आपने? छेद करने के लिए paper, spiral bind करने के लिए punching machine. तो ऐसे X-ray में punch होता था. Normal bone और देख रहे हो आप osteoporosis की bone. Trabecular होते ही नहीं है, देखिए ऐसे. ये punch. पूरी bone ऐसे. Bone बचती ही नहीं है. That's osteoporosis. Small joints get inflamed in gout arthritis. Next question on screens, please. Come on, full Josh. The code is 243847. Age-related disorder X. Decreased bone mass. बेचारा, मैंने आपको कल भी बोला था, old person bathroom में slip कर जाते हैं. मीपन मराठी, पे अटेंशन. मीपन इंडियन. इज इट मायसिनिया ग्रेविस, मस्कुलर डिस्ट्रोफी? मस्कुलर डिस्ट्रोफी विल बी बिकॉज ऑफ द पर्सन्स इनएबिलिटी टू वॉक. यस, ओ ये क्या किया आप लोगों ने? व्हाट जस्ट हैपेंड? No, it's not myasthenia gravis, it's B. It's B. No. It's a wrong mentee ji bichare ko breakfast mein bhook lagi hai. No, it's osteoporosis. Don't worry, it's a wrong tagging of the question. Yaar, mentee ji ne gadbad ki aur it's a wrong tagging. Right, it is osteoporosis. Increased chance of fracture, decreased bone mass. Myasthenia is droopy eyes. Myasthenia is because of neuromuscular junction. Fatigue, weakening of skeletal system. Bechara, mentee, bhookha ho gaya hai. Uske breakfast ka time ho gaya hai. Yes, autoimmune disorder, neuromuscular junction ko affect karte hain. Right everybody? So, agar humne isko close hi kar diya hai, antibody bana di hai, the sodium ions are not able to go inside, right? Neuromuscular junction mein maine kitni baar padhaya, dekhi antibody ban gayi hai. This is myasthenia gravis and I have told you myasthenia gravis mein kaun suffer karta hai? Amitabh Bachchan is suffering from myasthenia gravis. Chaliye. Osteoporosis se not associated hai, bataiye. Aisha Sareen, how are you my dear child? Kya ho gaya Sandeep Kumar, Gayatri, Pallavi? Which of the following is not associated? Very good. It happens in women after menopause. So it's very common in women over the age of 50. It's not common in men because men have testosterone which does not decrease. So it is related to, very good. I want ma'am ne bola in this. Very good. Decreased levels of estrogen after menopause. Estrogen helps in calcium deposition in the bones. Very, very important. That is why women, and that is why, you know, one of the major treatments, I remember when we were in college, we were taught this, that one of the major treatments of osteoporosis is hormone replacement therapy. So after the age of 55, if you see any of your relatives, any of your, you know, senior relatives taking hormone tablets after 55, 56, 58 years of age, why has a doctor given estrogen after 55 years of age? For treating osteoporosis. Did you understand this? Because estrogen helps in absorption of calcium and deposition of calcium on the bones. So if somebody has osteoporosis, along with daily calcium, vitamin D is important because vitamin D helps in absorption of calcium. After that, we need to give them estrogen replacement therapies, hormonal replacement therapies, because without estrogen, you will not be able to absorb the calcium. Do you understand this? Right? Causative factors are sex hormones also. Calcitonin, parathormone तो कम नहीं होगा, but because sex hormones कम हो जाते हैं. और एक major problem जो लोग करते हैं, अगर आपके घर में भी किसी को weakness है, वो calcium के tablet खाते रहेंगे, vitamin D नहीं खाएंगे. Vitamin D के बिना कभी भी calcium absorb नहीं हो सकता है. जैसे vitamin C के बिना iron absorb नहीं हो सकता. They help as cofactors. Remember these two things. Vitamin D के बिना आप calcium नहीं absorb कर सकते. Vitamin C, नींबू के बिना आप iron absorb नहीं कर सकते. Understood? Very important. चलिए next one. Accumulation of urea in the blood. We've done this so many times. चलिए golden tip. बिल्कुल अरविंद आज की golden tip हो गई है. चलिए गौरव. Okay, crystal clear. सुबलेखा कैसे हो आप? Gul, long time no see. Gul, how are you? How's the weather there? Sonal, Ajmera, come on, quick. Accumulation of urea in the blood is known as uremia, urosis, uricosis, urasis. What is halitosis? One extra question for you. What is halitosis? I've done it so many times. Ma'am ne bola, halitosis is bad smell which comes from the mouth, which comes in exam. Another question which comes is uremia, accumulation of urea in the blood. Due to malfunctioning of kidney, urea can be removed by hemodialysis. If the kidneys fail, we have to do hemodialysis. Very good. Well done. 243847 hai wo bachche jo abhi join kar rahe hain hame, jo quiz nahi de pa rahe hain. Chaliye. टेटनी. अरे वेटर्स टिप टेकिंग पोजिशन. चॉपस्टिक साइन सर्जरी का फेवरेट क्वेश्चन होता है. चॉपस्टिक साइन टेटनी. हाइपोकैल्सेमिक टेटनी. इज इट सृष्टि डू आई स्पीक लाइक दैट? हॉई मजा आ रहा है, बड़ा मजा आ रहा है ना पढ़ने में. नेक्स्ट ईयर ना आप लोग कॉलेज आओगे, मैं आपको ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी पढ़ाना शुरू करूंगी. When you go to college, next year I'll take lessons. आप लोग कॉलेज से ज्वाइन करना अपने कॉलेज से. हम लोग सब मिलकर ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी पढ़ेंगे. ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी तो मुझे बहुत अच्छी लगती है, पर उसके लिए आप सबको कॉलेज जाना पड़ेगा. टेटनी. वाइल्ड, ऐसे वाइल्ड रिलैक्सेशन नहीं होता, स्लो सस्टेन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन होता है. स्लो सस्टेन वाइल्ड रिलैक्सेशन नहीं, ऐसे ऐसे वाइल्ड रिलैक्सेशन नहीं. While relaxations are something, or over sustained contractions are something which happens in epilepsy. कभी आपने किसी को घर के बाहर, it's called as a मिर्की का दौरा in Hindi, epilepsy fits. Have you heard anybody tonic clonic seizures? मैंने आपको बोला था, right? That happens in epilepsy. Here there are very slow and sustained contractions. Right everybody? Slow, sustained contractions. So while contractions is a wrong statement. Did I tell you about waiter's tip taking position, hand be aise banta hai, chopstick sign. Very important. Muscular disorder in which rapid spasms and muscles occur due to less calcium. Muscle cramps, spasms and tremors, slow, sustained contractions, not rapid contractions. Right everybody? That's hypocalcemic tetany. We've discussed it so many times. Spasms bina aapko bolta nas chadti hai. कल एक वर्ड यूज किया था, मैंने बोला था आंख ऐसे ऐसे करती, फिर आप अपनी मम्मी के पास जाओगे, मम्मी देखो मेरी आंख को क्या हो गया, राइट है लेफ्ट है, एग्जाम से पहले कौन सी अच्छी होती है बुरी होती है, ऑल ऑफ दैट है ना. सो दैट इज योर टेटनी. चलिए वन मोर क्वेश्चन, कम ऑन. कितने बच्चे आएंगे एनसीईआरटी मार्किंग? कितने बच्चे आएंगे आज इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसपोर्ट चेन पढ़ने? विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट एसोसिएटेड विद मस्कुलर डिस्ट्रोफी? मस्कुलर डिस्ट्रोफी. Oh, Sai Mritvika, thank you so much. Muscular dystrophy. There's a protein which is called dystrophin which is produced. It's a disease that causes progressive weakness and loss of muscle mass. There are many, many kinds of muscular dystrophies. It's basically because of mutations. Which of the following is not, affects neuromuscular junctions? Not really, right? And causes tetany? No, it does not cause tetany. Dystrophin is a is like a paralysis which is slowly taking place in the body. When the child is born, most of the children are normal. Slowly, steadily, over a period of time, they lose all control over their muscles. Inborn genetic abnormality of muscle associated with dysfunction. Ultimately, itna deterioration hota hai, maine aapko bola dystrophin protein banta hai, jo neuromuscular junctions ko destroy kar deta hai, and over a period of time, you have no control over your muscles. Weakness, shrinking ho jati hai, dekho muscles ki. Normal biceps dekho, kitne shrink ho gaye hain. Dikh rahe hain aapko, destroy ho jayenge. Shrink ho jayenge. Itne shrink aur destroy ho jayenge that it is not possible to do any work. Just not possible to do any work. Yay! Iti Divya Vandana Charu Lavya Katiyar Kajal Divya Velumuri Long Time No See Naina and Arunima. And ET, whatever that stands for, is the topper. I quite like the look of yours. You look like a extraterrestrial object. ET, extraterrestrial, not bad. Looks like Jadu only. So that's great. That's amazing. Well done, guys. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe before you go. And most importantly, I'm going to see you sharp at 10 o'clock with Electron Transport Chain. Bye. Bye, kids. See you at 10 o'clock for Electron Transport Chain. Yes? Bye. Tell me your scores in +4, -1. I'll be waiting for your scoreboard. Bye-bye.